moving on to a very special address speaker. He is the managing director, TTK Prestige. The purpose of the kitchen appliances and cookware brand, it is to provide quality consumer products at affordable prices. Caldo tells us how the brand has maintained its consistency or purpose and how the brand's expression has evolved over the time. He will also share his insights on why it is important for brands to find their purpose and how marketing has changed the way the activity now towards building a relationship rather than being transactional. It's an honor and very delighted to welcome among us the Managing Director, TTK Prestige, Mr. Chandru Caldo with us right now with a big round of applause. Sir, good evening.
Thank you.
Namaskara, Hegidira.
Thank you so much for that introduction. And you know, when you come in at 6:20 in the evening and there are so many eminent speakers who have spoken before you, and I don't know what they've spoken. So if I'm repeating what has been said, then I can be very satisfied saying good minds think alike. And I can apologize for having bored everybody with the same things again. So please bear with me if I'm repeating things.
All right, sir. I'm sure you will not repeat. Even if you repeat, it's going to be reiterating certain points, which is a good advantage to all of us. So thank you so much again, sir. And like they say in Karnataka, namaskara. And I hope you're very good. So over to you, sir. Thank you.
Yeah. If you don't mind, I will share a presentation. I have made a presentation.
Please, sir.
Is my screen visible?
Yes, it is.
Okay, just give me a minute. I'll go on to slideshow. Yeah, as the topic said, I'm talking about building a business and brand with purpose. And I think it's a very relevant topic for today, you know, and because there are some big trends that I believe define today. First, there is an information overload. Today, all of us are more informed than ever before on every subject. And if we don't have that information, we know where to find it. Second thing is we are all very connected, but also very disconnected. I mean, how many times have you gone across a dining table and found three people eating together and they are not connected with each other and all of them are on their mobiles? But that's the world we live in today. And therefore, there is a lot of impatience. All these are actually important trends. And then this economy of free, I mean, free, as we know, is the most profitable business on this planet today. If you don't believe it, please look at Google, please look at Facebook and how profitable they have been by offering free services. Everything today is shared because we want to share it. And then we also say that we want privacy. So there are so many contradictions today in people, in me and in you and everybody. For us, we want everything on demand, anytime, anywhere. That's the world we live in today. So these are some random thoughts and random trends that I'm putting together. The other thing is there is this constantly evolving delivery systems of products and services. I mean, just think how the Swiggies, how the Ubers and the Olas of the world have delivered services to us or the Dunzos, how products today are being delivered online through e-commerce. All of this was not there maybe just 10 years back. And this new trend of environment, sustainability and governance that has become very important for all companies, all brands. All brands want to be present in this list of good ESG, which I think is important. And you can see that there is something like a purpose evolving from an ESG kind of thought, an on-demand, anywhere, anytime kind of thought, an impatience kind of trend, etc., etc. Now, what do brands actually fight for? Think about it. Do they fight for profits? They do. Do they fight for sustainability? Of course. Do they fight for market share and leadership? I think that's what we want to die for. And of course, growth. Now, all of these, if we want, we have to go beyond what we used to do yesterday. The pure play product or services company does not exist, in my opinion. Every company has both. And if a company thinks they are only selling a product and not a service, they will soon be extinct, and vice versa. Therefore, for marketing, the key implication is that the standard feature benefit statement today is outdated. If you think that you will just talk, call out features and benefits and manage to sell your product because your product is differentiated, just that much is not enough. So what I believe, therefore, is there must be a higher purpose which you need to communicate, which is what I guess the theme of today's discussion is. And how do I find that purpose? How do I find my purpose of existence, my company, my brand's purpose of existence? Why should I exist? I think we should all ask ourselves this question as often as we can, so that we constantly bother to reinvent ourselves true to the purpose with which we started this exercise. Because you don't change your purpose every day. Ask yourself, what do I offer? What do I offer to the customer? I mean, this is something that we live in TTK Prestige on. I'm saying, what am I offering and why should I exist? Because there are many people who make the same kind of products that we sell. Who am I relevant to? Who do I want to be relevant to? What do I fight for? And why me? And I think this is a question that you must have heard several speakers talk about today, I'm sure. The why me question is critical before you get into the business. Now, therefore, when you are looking at having a purpose that is going to encompass these thoughts, then marketing obviously will change, because companies that answer those questions then have one major task to perform. If they have identified a purpose for which they are going to exist, which is going to define what they offer, which is going to tell them why them and not anyone else, then the next job that they have to do is align everyone in the company with a clearly articulated purpose so that everyone is on the same page. Because I'll show you what happens if that doesn't happen. So the moment you align everybody towards that purpose, you will find that marketing will then become more and more about relationship building and less transactional. And that is so critical in today's world, where retaining a customer has become so important for maintenance and growth of revenues. So purpose, I think, is the very soul of the brand and company. I mean, if you are talking about a product being the body, I think the purpose with which you brought that product is the very soul of that brand. It's something that is the core philosophy. Some people articulate it through their vision statement, some people articulate it through their mission statement, but it is sometimes not completely articulated, but it is at the core of the philosophy or the culture of the company. And brand purpose, therefore, is far more encompassing than the 4 P's of marketing or the 5 C's or whatever you call it. And therefore, it is far more important. And everything actually stems from this. So how does one find that purpose, align the organization, and then turn into expressing that purpose? And here is where the most important thing is for marketing guys. Whose point of view? With whose point of view will you express that purpose? Clearly, it has to be the customer's point of view. Otherwise, the customer is not going to be interested for a long period of time to engage with the company or the brand. And this is something that many people don't do, and therefore, actually, the customer switches off. Another random thought that came when I was making this presentation was, I was looking at all the successful startups that we have, and living in Bangalore, we have most of these startups. And if you see their philosophy, largely it comes through this gene code. They identify a problem which is real and which no one has thought of bothering to solve, and they offer a solution. They do not try, the successful startup does not try to change the habit of the consumer. And they keep the solution simple. Now think of all the startups that have created this kind of thing, an Uber or Ola or a Swiggy or a Dunzo or any of these people who've come, they've identified real problems which have been lying around for tens of years. But they've used technology to offer a solution that is so easy to adapt to and adopt. And then they keep the company scalable if they can offer that product or service to more and more people seamlessly. They stay relevant with the changes in the environment. And they build an ecosystem that's good for everyone, all stakeholders. So if you can imagine the number of people who've got employment because of all these startups which I mentioned, and today many of them are unicorns. Think of how many people have actually benefited from this entire game. And the best part is the successful startup actually empowers every stakeholder. And that is what I mean by having a good purpose to actually create a brand and a company. Established companies and brands, on the other hand, have certain problems with them because they are set in their processes and their thinking. They're more inside out than outside in. And I'll give you a couple of examples which you will immediately identify with. They tend to work within self-imposed boundaries. They tend to forget sometimes that the most important part, which is the customer, as they evolve. And the purpose of the brand sometimes is forgotten. So the idea is, if an established company wants to sustain itself, wants to continue answering that why me question, which I spoke of, then they've got to constantly evolve, but never lose sight of the original purpose. Business models are evolving. There is a sharing economy that's fast developing. Customer engagement, therefore, is fast changing in character. But businesses and brands that remember the purpose with which they began, they will evolve along with the customer. They are not going to be saying that it is my way or the highway. Because if they do that, they will fall by the wayside. So if the purpose is not based, this is my firm opinion, and I'm sure most of you agree, if it's not based on the customer's point of view, it's not sustainable. If every stakeholder in the system does not win, you shouldn't be doing it. Now, why? Because we all deal with human beings. And I think when you are talking about a purpose, it's about connecting beyond the five senses that we are usually connecting to, of touch, feel, taste, sight, and hearing. It's ideal to go beyond those five senses, and that is, you touch the heart and soul. And to do that, you need to have a shared purpose. Unless you have that shared purpose, you find that shared purpose, you're not going to go beyond the five senses. You're not going to go deep inside. What happens with a great sense of empathy? This happens only when you have a great sense of empathy and a complete shedding of ego, that it is I who is giving this. My purpose of existence is because of the customer. I'm not saying something that's new, but I think it's extremely relevant. And more importantly, constantly speaking with the customer. Now, this is something that we at TTK always do constantly. And I think I'm giving you two examples here, and you know both these examples. Both had brutal market shares. I have deliberately kept the byline in that logo. Nokia connecting people. Let's talk about Nokia connecting people. They thought they were in the job of connecting people. And what did someone like Apple come and do? They connected people even better. And Nokia decided that the Symbian operating system doesn't have to change. And if it changes, it is at their pace and not because the customer was looking for something different. And what the rest is history. We know what happened to Nokia. It's reinventing itself. The same happens with Kodak. Look at the byline, share moments, share life. And what did they do? They had the first digital camera, really. They had the first shareable photographic machine. And they decided that they won't launch it and won't give the consumer the benefit of that. And what happened later is history. So brands which do not have their purpose shared with the customer, I think these are two classic examples of what happens when they don't continuously go on that path. It was not technology, it was not competition, it was not complacency. It was this lack of understanding of this purpose with which they actually wrote those lines on those logos that actually brought them down. So the key reason, therefore, is disconnect with that purpose. We at TTK Prestige, I'm happy to say, we put the customer first in the most relevant manner. We constantly talk to them. You know, this is our mission statement when we actually started the company: quality consumer products at affordable prices. It seems like a perfectly nice, reasonable line, but I think that is the purpose with which and the philosophy by which we have actually launched products. Now, when we started the company, it was a period in 1950s where it was a period of shortages. So, I mean, quality consumer products, quality being underlined and affordable being underlined, I think was exceedingly relevant there. Post-90s, we know how this India has evolved. And so we evolved along, and now we say we want to delight homemakers with innovation and provide solutions and not products. And that is something at the core of everything that we do. We want to provide a solution and not products. Our journey to finding that solution is to deliver, and deliver on the purpose is simply, we do this in these four-step ways. We understand current lifestyles. We understand key concerns of life. Nobody articulates a product to us. We understand what brings them happiness, what brings them problems. And then we try and express all of that with a solution which hopefully delights the customer. This is the simple framework which we find. And we launch more than 100 products every year, year after year, for the last 15 years at least we've been doing this. And our pillars of product development and communication are health, convenience, time saving, and aesthetic, which we believe for all homemakers today, these are the four most relevant issues in their mind. So the brand purpose is at our very core, and it comes before we actually make a product or conceive a service. And what we say is that the intent must be to deliver on that purpose, but we are flexible on the approach with which we deliver on that purpose. And we always say that if all stakeholders don't benefit, we don't go that way. To sum up, purpose precedes all marketing communication and is the soul of all that communication. Consistency is exceedingly important. And for consistency, alignment across the company is critical. And lastly, customer centricity is paramount. If you can deliver value that will go beyond the P&L, that is good for you because the P&L will fall in place. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you so much, sir. That was just amazing. And I like how you put things simple most way. And the maximum one can learn from you. I still remember there was a commercial ad back in the days. Jo BBC kare pyaar. Wo Prestige ko kaise kaise inkar. I want to understand one quick thing. How did you come out with a campaign like this?
So I'll tell you how. I mean, it's a very interesting story. I mean, we came up with a safety feature in a pressure cooker.
Right.
Okay, it was called the gasket release system. And we said, how are we going to actually communicate this? I mean,
right. The
first way was to say, here we have a gasket release system and your pressure cooker is completely safe. But then I think full marks to the ad agency MA and Sadhika Peerboy, who actually created that campaign, and she came up with this idea saying, and those were the days when husbands used to buy things for their wives, not like today. And she said, then you have that situation in the shop where the husband and wife are going to buy, and the shopkeeper says, well, I'll give you a normal, ordinary pressure cooker if you just about love your wife. But if you really love your wife, you must buy a Prestige. And that's how Jo Baby Se Kare Pyaar, because you're concerned about her safety. So it was a safety-led very innovative ad. We, of course, say it in a different context today. And we change the line, jo apno se kare pyar, jo suvidha se kare pyar, jo TV se kare pyar. So it's not the BV alone that we are doing PR now.
But I like how the word PR has evolved with prestige, and that's a true sense of the brand that holds the key for consumers. And this whole campaign is one of those most, somebody can remember it very easily. It's in the whole people's mind, people still remember. And it was so heart touching because the ad explains it, why prestige in general. The safety feature was explained so well. So I want to give this to you. I'm sure you've got this many times, but a round of applause to you and your team.
Thank you.